Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. I am Arnab Das, and today I will be discussing with you about a cool robot controller board, that is this one. This is Romeo version 1.3 and it's manufactured by dfrobot.com. This is quite an interesting one because it is having an Arduino Uno that is quite open source and an inbuilt motor driver board. Yeah, the DC motor driver board, that is the L298. This one is quite interesting because this thing comes really cheap, like $29.5, and you can buy it from their website dfrobot.com. The most awesome feature of this board is that it is gold plated. All the contacts, the header pins, all are gold plated. Like nowadays, where do you find gold plated stuff, right? All are cheap hardware, they just put anything around, nickel and all stuff. But this one is really gold plated, so you very less contact resistance, and that's gonna be important because if you are developing a product, you don't want to like play with random resistance in between the wires. So okay, we'll go into the specification of this particular board in depth. Let's go.
Okay guys, so coming to the specification of this particular board, this is having a 80 mega 328p and it is having a Arduino Uno bootloader. So like if you are having previous sketch made for Arduino, that particular sketch will work fine in it. Just you may have to change some pins because the motor driver uses 4 pins of this Arduino, and though you can enable or disable at any time. As like Arduino, it is having 14 channel digital I/O, and out of which 6 channels are PWM channels and 8 are 10 bit analog I/O. So like you can read as well as analog data as well as digital, and you can write digital, and you can also give output in PWM. And like other features, like it is having USB interface for programming as like Arduino, and it is having a ICSP header to program it using a USB ASP or similar serial programming devices. It supports a socket for Bluetooth module and APC220 RF modules. It is having 5 pair of I2C pins, and those are like placed in the corner, so easy to access. It is having one cool feature is that it has both the male as well as female headers. So if you want like some of the hardware may come with female or male variants, so that now you are having a flexibility, whereas in original Arduino Uno it's like it is having only female headers. And all of the Arduino hardware is compatible with this, so like if you are having some Arduino shield or anything, it will be fully compatible. There will be no problem in the compatibility part. Another cool feature is that as it is using L298, so it can support 2 ampere in each motor, as well as you can control the motor in PWM as well as PLL, so like pulse width modulation and phase lock loop. So that is a cool feature for controlling more motors, because when you are doing robotics project, you need lot of motor control. And there is another option is that if you are using lot of servos, then you may need external power, because from USB or like you can get 500 milliampere to 1 ampere depending on the port. So like for like if you are using 3-4 servos, you need like 1 or 2 ampere of current, so you can give the power from external connector available on the board, and it automatically shifts from internal to external when needed. As well as to power the board, you can use a DC 7 to 12 volt supply, and for motor you can use separate power, or you can use the internal oil as well, but usually you need separate because motor usually will take a lot of current. Another cool feature is that it is having five push buttons which are connected to the single pin, that is the A7 analog pin. That means all are connected via resistance, and so you have to read the particular voltage on the A7 pin to check that which particular pin is which particular button is pressed. Coming to the like the pin configuration of this board, you can see that in the top left we are having the servo power input, so it automatically gets selected if you give servo power, because when you are making using 3-4 servos, then you need some external power to power it, not from the main source. This is the main DC source, and this is the USB used for both for programming. You can also use it to power the board, like if you do some small applications with very less power consumption, then this one also runs well. In the below, in this yellow, it is the buttons, all the five buttons that is connected to the A7 pin, and this thing you have to do some analog reading and programming here to identify the button. These all are the analog input rest, and here at the right we are having the I2C pinout. We are having five pair of I2C, so like you can connect five I2C device. You can always extend it, because theoretically I2C you can go up to 127 slabs. And we are having here the Bluetooth socket, and we are having the motor power in as well as the power selector, and these two are the motor driver motor outputs for the two motors. This is the motor driver, and the top, this one is the motor selector, like you want to go for PWM or PLL kind of control, as well as you can enable or disable the motor driver from here. This whole thing is the digital IO. So this is the our 80 mega 328p. This is the overall the board. Let's go to the schematic. Okay, so this is the power section of the board, you can see, and coming up, this is the all the IO, how the IO is placed. Right to this, here we are having the our L298 SO20 package. So like it can handle 2 ampere of current per motor, but I will suggest that if you are going to drive it for very long, like then you can put a little fan over it to cool it down quickly. And we are having back EMF protection here, and here we are having we are using four pins of the Arduino, in which two are for enable and two are for the direction control. So 5 and 6 is for the enable, that is will control the speed, and we are having the 4 and 7 for direction control. Okay, this is the 80 mega 8U2 for the programming. This is how the switch is connected, all the push buttons, and as I said, all are connected through resistance. So if like I press this button, that is S5, then this all the resistance gets added up, and there is will get a voltage here that we can calculate using the voltage divider particular calculation we have to do, and then we can figure out which particular button I have pressed. This is so this is what it is, the schematic, and as I have told before, this is the layout. With this board we can do a lot of projects. Some of the project idea will be like line follower robots or obstacle avoider, or maybe like your own RC car, anything, anything, you can make anything. Its possibility is endless. As you can see, it's like it's having the motor driver inbuilt, so you don't have to take much like extra hardware to put for the driving the motor. Yeah, definitely if you need more number of motors to control, then you have to add other motor drivers. But whatever it is given, I think for most of the application, for hobby or something like for your college projects, two motors are enough, and you have lot of servo, so that will be enough, I guess. And coming to the like, it is having the buttons in it, so like let's take the condition of a line folder robot. So you need lot of buttons to configure, like okay, stop or start the robot, like those kind of thing can be easily programmed in it. All the buttons are inbuilt, so you don't have to like add some buttons, do some circuit or anything. It's quite easy then for you to really save time and just focus on the programming, not much on the hardware part. Then you can like develop some good algorithms, all those things will come up.
Thank you guys for watching my video. I hope you liked it. If you like it, then give a thumbs up, share it, comment, and if you feel like exploring more, go check out the description. There will be links, and check out my other videos of the projects, like the drawing machine or maybe the Picasso. Okay, see you guys. See you next time. Bye. Let it go, let my body go. Take our bodies higher and higher.